Other news now. NATO and European Union members Estonia and Latvia tell their Russian ambassadors to leave. That's after Moscow said it was downgrading diplomatic relations with Estonia and told its envoy to leave the Russian Federation by February 7th. The measure comes after Estonia drastically reduced staff levels at Russia's embassy in the capital, Tallinn. It's the first time Russia has expelled the ambassador of an EU country since it launched its invasion of Ukraine. The Baltic states of Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania have been among a group of NATO allies arguing strongly for Germany to provide its Leopard tanks to boost Kyiv's ability to fight off Russian troops. Pakistan begins restoring power to millions of people after a grid failure triggered the country's worst blackout in months. Over 22 million Pakistanis were without electricity on Monday due to a voltage surge on the country's grid in the south. The power outage lasted more than 12 hours. The government assures the public it is working to fully restore power in the affected areas. It also launched an inquiry on the incident. Both government officials and experts blame the country's power problems to outdated electricity network and infrastructure. The World Health Organization calls for a concerted action to protect children from contaminated medicines. In a statement Monday, the WHO said more than 300 children died last year of acute kidney injury associated with contaminated cough syrups. The deaths were reported in Gambia, Indonesia, and Uzbekistan. The medicines manufactured by two Indian pharmaceuticals reportedly contained high levels of toxic chemicals. The WHO has told Reuters four more countries, including the Philippines, may be potentially impacted as they may have procured the medicines. It urged nations to ensure medical products are approved by regulators and remove from markets any substandard medicines that it identified as potential causes of deaths and disease.